What up, gamers? It's Mace from Teamheadkick. We are continuing with Lollipop Chainsaw. This is stage 3, the Obannon Farm. I think this is the third video for this stage I've made so far. Number 12, if you're keeping up with the whole thing, we need to shoot these zombies off of this tractor immediately. Double backflips. Boom. I'm going to go ahead and eat this lollipop real quick before I grab that one. Keep my energy up to max. And now I need to rescue this motherfucker. Let's hack some zombies. All of these survivors give you a ton of coins when you rescue them, so you want to do it. If you don't rescue them in time, these zombies will kill them. And then they turn into powerful zombies themselves, kind of like mini bosses, so... Yeah, definitely want to kill him. I was capturing this gameplay earlier, having a good old time, and lo and behold, a friggin' earthquake hit. I live in Los Angeles. I don't even really get out of bed if it's anything less than a 5.0 these days. Gotta be totally honest. They just, little quakes don't scare me anymore. When I first moved to LA, I did not like them. And you know, it's funny, I got a lot of friends that live on the East Coast. Got a couple of friends that live in Kansas. They deal with tornadoes. I'm like, fuck that. I am not a fan of tornadoes. And then my friends that live on the far East Coast, you know, Florida and whatnot, they deal with fucking hurricanes. And I tell you what, me personally, I would much rather deal with an earthquake any day than a hurricane. I've been in some powerful earthquakes in my day, including the Northridge quake in the 90s. That was a 6.4 that shook the shit out of everything. It was pretty crazy, but anyway, yeah, that's just me talking about earthquakes. I don't know why, but I decided to go ahead and keep doing this video, even with the earthquake. My power didn't go out. It was no big deal. And you know what I think's really funny is the news around here makes such a big deal out of it. I mean, if we have just a little shaker that doesn't even, you know, bother my dogs or rock my fish tank, if I flip the news on, they're talking about, oh, it's the apocalypse, better stock up and buy all the water and shit you need. And I'm like, you are apocalypse noobs. You guys have no idea how to survive an apocalypse. Us gamers, we're going to do all right. When the shit hits the fan, we know what is going on. But enough about that. We'll get back into the game here. I'm rocking my chainsaw blaster, taking out some fat dudes. There's coins up there, but you can't get them from here. You actually have to go around the corner, and there's a little trampoline mini game. But I'm going to go ahead and skip that shit. And just go ahead and pop the head on Nick here. These are the gayest minigames ever. And by gayest, I mean colorful, fruity, loving the penis minigames. I don't discriminate. If you love the cock, that's your business and that's awesome. But this is just gay. It's happy with hearts and dancing and pressing buttons and... Yay! And it makes me wonder kind of why they added that to the game, just because this is definitely an adult-themed game. The humor cusses a lot, all that fun stuff. This is a cool little mini-game. The zombies come up out of the ground. We got to shoot them before they get to the bus. And they got that dynamite on them. The first few of them move real slow, so it is not a problem. But as it speeds up, it gets a little tougher. I've said it in other videos, I'm not a fan of the auto-aim in this game. I think it's friggin' terrible. And you know, I hate it when there's a game that I'm into that I like all the way around, you know, and there's just one facet that just sucks about it. And while there are plenty of things that I can bitch about with this game, including the playthrough is not very long, none of them compare when it comes to the auto-aim on this gun. It is god-awful. I was watching the news today, too. Did you guys hear about this? There was a kid playing Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, played for 4 days without a break, and then he passed out. His mom took away his Xbox, and I'm like, what a friggin' noob. Like, listen, most of you guys that watch my videos, we are all hardcore gamers. I've had some pretty epic sessions. In fact, I have had 72-hour straight sessions. We did one for Halo years ago for a charity. and it was a breast cancer awareness thing. We raised a bunch of money through Bungie. It was a lot of fun, but I knew to get up and go to the bathroom. I knew to take a break when I needed to. I knew to eat some food. I mean, I hate it when gamers do stuff like that. It makes us look bad as gamers. So here's a little section with some tractors. I got to shoot these motherfuckers before they get to that boulder, because if I don't, they're going to drop it on my head. This is easy. Bing, bang, and boom. And we are moving on. So yeah, anyway, back to the news story. It pisses me off, you know? I really hate people that give gamers a bad name, because for me, I'm trying to give gaming a good name. You know, I'm one of those guys that I game pretty much 24/7. It's what I do for a job, and it's just a lot of fun. You know, I enjoy it. And I hate it when people say that video games cause violence, and video games make you hurt people, and video games blah, 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 blah. It's a bunch of politicians that got nothing better to do, and none of those guys are fucking gamers. You know they're not. None of those guys are gamers. So anyway, yeah, I guess I can move on. I'm sorry, I've been just ranting my ass off. That's Juliet covering her ass if you try to stare at it. Which is kind of funny. I wish they wouldn't have done that in the game either, because I like to stare at chicks' asses. Why would they block that? That is a fail on the programmer's part.
It's another one of those mushrooms, Juliet.
Let me go ahead and take care of these horses real quick. There's a bunch of undead creatures in this stage because it's a farm. And if you hit them and don't kill them, they will get pissed off and start bucking around and kick you. But the only reason I'm killing these things is because fuck PETA. Just kidding. No, I'm killing them because they give you coins, and you need to get a ton of coins in this level. Let's go ahead and go to the mini boss here. Yeah. This is trippy, like eating a mushroom. It's like if you ate mushrooms and had lollipops with a little zombie hand. There you go. That's our cut screen. And if you guys watched the last video, we had a mini boss that was like this. It was a huge chicken. Now we gotta fight three huge chickens. Trace Pollo. Yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do some damage right away here. Get out of the friggin' way. I actually kind of like this color scheme, and this is only happens on this level. But it looks pretty cool with the whole black and white thing. I think they should have used that more. It's fun. But you got three chickens. Once you get their health down, you're going to do a button masher here, lop their heads off. Pretty self-explanatory. They make funny sounds when they hop around. Speaking of chickens, man, fuck Chick-fil-A. You guys heard about that? That's been all over Twitter and Facebook as well. Chick-fil-A's owner is some anti-gay guy, which, you know what? That's your opinion. If you want to be anti-gay, fine, but don't be spreading anti-gay hate. You know what I mean? Like, it's just ridiculous, especially when you own a company. Shit just pisses me off. And you know what's funny? Because their corporate logo is a huge cock. So that's, you know, it cracks me up. Like, corporate logo is a huge cock and I'm going to be anti-gay. It just doesn't even make sense. So once you kill all three chickens and cut all their heads off, they get attached to some arms here. And then you got to fight these guys. Again, they're going to shoot bubbles at you. And but it's not hard. You're going to shoot them from a distance. Once they get down close, jump out of the way, and then they'll stay there for a quick second. You can go up and do some chopping here. Whoa, that was weird. That was like a little freeze there. But you know what I'm going to do, guys? Because I want to save you from having to watch 20 minutes of video per time. I'm going to go ahead and cut it after this boss fight, and then we will move on with the O'Bannon Farm Stage 3 of Lollipop Chainsaw. And I'm bringing you guys a full playthrough. You gotta bear with me because it's gonna take me probably a month to upload all this footage. And it's just because it takes forever. You know, I always wonder when gamers and other fellow machinima directors, when they just upload a ton of footage. And you guys know what I'm talking about. Guys that upload like 5 videos a day. I don't know how the hell they do that. I work really hard at doing this stuff. I play nonstop. I edit nonstop. And I'm bringing them to you guys as fast as I can. So, that is it. That is the boss, and we are moving on. It is your boy Mace from Team Headkick. Make sure to check out all of my videos. Make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.